Welcome to the physics class. We are here once again with a very important topic in physics, that is Gauss's theorem. Today we wish to state and verify Gauss's theorem. So let's proceed. Let us state the Gauss's theorem. Gauss's theorem is very fundamental law in electrostatic, let me tell you. And let's state, the law states that the total flux through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon times the net charge enclosed by that closed surface. I repeat once again, the net flux through a closed surface, the total flux through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon times the net charge enclosed by that closed surface. So it's very clear that Gauss's theorem is applicable to only enclosed surfaces. So let's verify the same. For that, we'll consider a charge, say for example positive charge, and we wish we'll draw a sphere of radius r around it, being the charge as its center. Supposing r is the radius, so r is the radius of that sphere. Charge is placed at the center of sphere and we consider a small surface area, say for example ds, small surface area ds, this is small surface area ds. Since this is positive charge, it will give out electric field lines in an outward direction. This way, this is how it will give electric field lines. These are the field lines going radially outward. Okay, now let us say this is a point P. So the net electric field at a point P, the net electric field at a point P is 1 upon the charge upon square of the distance. The distance is R, square of the distance therefore R square, and its direction is outward. Why outward? Because for positive charge, field lines move radially outward. Now, the total number of field lines passing through this surface, small surface, the total flux passing through the small surface is, according to definition, is electric field dot product of field and the surface area. Therefore, the net flux passing through the surface, ये जो surface है, इसमें से कितना flux pass out हुआ है, will get by integrating all this small flux like this over a closed surface is equal to, therefore, replace the value of d phi, that's E dot ds. Okay, enclosed surface, so enclosed symbol we have to keep. Let's keep. Now E dot ds can also be written as E, magnitude of E, magnitude of ds, magnitude of cos of theta. Now being theta 0 degree, cos of 0 degree is 1, so this value can be replaced. So we have the net flux through the enclosed surface is equal to magnitude of field, is this only magnitude we have to take, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught that charge upon square of the distance multiplied by the surface area. Now the surface area, whole surface area is, and that's 1, cos 0 degree is 1, so it's 1. So finally we have phi equals to, what is left is 1 upon epsilon times the charge enclosed by it, and this is what Gauss's theorem, this is what your Gauss's theorem. So here we proved the Gauss's theorem. So this is how easily we can prove Gauss's theorem. Once again, let us state the Gauss's theorem. The flux passing through a closed surface is 1 by epsilon times the charge enclosed by it. Remember one thing, Gauss's theorem is applicable to only enclosed surfaces. Moreover, the surfaces which follows Gauss's theorem, we call them as Gaussian surfaces. In next class, we are going to learn various application of Gauss's theorem. Thank you.